so, so, so much. I love you so, 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 so much. Hello, all you positive heads out there. Thanks for tuning your beautiful brainwaves into another episode of the Positive Head Podcast, where we are firmly convinced that creating success and happiness is rooted in understanding the ultimate nature of reality and the fact that as human beings, we are all immensely powerful fractals of the one and only source consciousness, which creates and animates all things. Now, of course, understanding this powerful truth is one thing. Applying this incredibly empowering wisdom to everyday life? Well, that's another. Which is exactly why we provide you with a fresh serving of Soul Food for Thought 5 days a week. To help constantly remind you of what matters most. You are it. And I'm your host, Brandon Beecham. I'm the reflection and extension of you who will be here each Wednesday interviewing a different consciousness changemaker. And on the other 4 weekdays, leading the way to ensure that your perspective is consistently expanded, your vibration is constantly elevated, and your heart is overflowing and full. Also, this episode of the Positive Head Podcast is being brought to you thanks to the support of Gaia. If you're not familiar, Gaia is the go-to source for streaming consciousness content online, and you can sign up for your first month for only 99 cents at gaia.com/positive head. That's spelled gaia.com/positive head. Check it out. All right, all you positive heads, welcome back to another episode. So happy to be here with you all. Also, very happy to have the lovely Sonya Sophia here to help steer the ship today. Freshly back from Burning Man and ready to connect with you guys. Hey there, Sonya. How are you?
Hi, Brandon. Thank you for inviting me back. It's such an honor.
You know what? I should have said that differently. Not only are you freshly back, you're freshly back a married woman. Congratulations.
Thank you. It's so true. I'm so happy.
Yeah, what an exciting thing. I just absolutely love your story. And you shared it the last time. Maybe give a quick, just real, you know, Cliff Notes version of how you ended up getting married this year at Burning Man, because I think it's so inspiring, especially to women, to empower women to go after what they want.
I mean, basically, I got up the courage to ask a man out, somebody that I really felt had a lot of integrity and had a really good reputation. And I tapped through my fear of being rejected and let him know I was interested in having a date. And after a few times of him telling me different reasons why he was busy or tired, I asked one final time on my birthday, and he said yes. And our next date was 3 days later on his birthday, and the rest is history.
Wow. Wow. Not only did you get up the courage to ask him out, you got turned down at first and you still persisted, and this ultimately led to your marriage. And I think it is like the most perfect story, especially for you who does the amazing work of helping to overcome fears. It's like you are truly like living, practicing what you preach in a way that has yielded like some really incredible things in your life. But what an amazing inspiration.
Well, thank you. You know, it seems like after you, learn to overcome fear in one area, it just should be easy. But what I've noticed is that every time I go to the next level, there's a different level of risk and fear of loss and fear of success. And that work has to be redone again to get to the next level. So on one level, I feel like I'm always at the beginning level, because that fear seems like I've never touched this. I've never been here. It's very raw and very real. And so I have a lot of compassion for people who are just now learning to turn and face their doubts and insecurities and panics and anxieties, because that's the process. But the result is that we do get rewarded for that. And we gain tremendously when we're willing to take those risks. And the universe rewards us for being bold and consistent in that process.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And like I said, you are definitely living proof of that. And of course, you're back at Burning Man for how many years now? Have you been leading taps at Red Lightning?
9 years at Red Lightning, 12 years on the Playa leading tapping, and then 18 years of attending. So it took me some time to get up the courage to give my gifts. And then I've been giving them consistently. And this year we tapped with about 3,000 people.
That's incredible. And, that's like, I mean, what percentages of that? There's 70,000 or so people at Burning Man. I mean, and there's so much to see and do and experience. Like, that many people came to see your tap is like, that's it. That's really a lot. I mean, I bet you're at the top of the list of people who drew a crowd, you know? That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, I think it's the most well-attended healing event that's been going on for some time. It took me a minute to really realize that. I was like, wow, this is a thing. Mm. And people build their burn around being able to calm and process. And it was really because of those events that I ended up building out what we have now online, because I was like, you know, people are coming year after year to do this work, but we need this work available more than once a year. We need to be doing this on a weekly basis to really move our culture forward. And I see that the young people who are going to these festivals, these, you know, who are seeking, they're the next level of visionaries and entrepreneurs. They're the people who are actually going to build out our culture in the next 20 years. And to be able to support them and to help them release fear and tune into love and be motivated from that deep, deep core truth is such an honor. It's such a gift. It makes me so happy.
Wow. Well, you are definitely doing amazing work. And actually, for those of you who haven't ever tuned into an episode with Sonya Sophia, she has been a guest multiple times, and she always is so gracious sharing a little preview of the type of work that she does, and we'll do that here in a little bit with a mini tap. And before we kind of jump into that, I would like to get your help answering a question. So, you know, the listeners oftentimes will write in questions. And by the way, guys, if you haven't written in a question and would like to, you can do so. My direct email, brandon@positivehead.com, or on the Facebook group, Positive Heads with an S. You can join there and connect with other amazing listeners and write questions there. And it's a private group, so you can sort of open up if, you know, it's things you don't want to share necessarily with the rest of the world on Facebook. But I received a question, and I thought you would be a great one to sort of talk about this one, because it's just a great question. So I'm going to take a moment and just read the question out loud, and then you can give your 2 cents. I'll give my 2 cents, and who knows, we might even get it to a full nickel's worth of information.
And
exactly. So here goes. So and this one requested to remain anonymous. So this person wrote in and said, hi, Brandon, I'm an avid listener to Positive Head Podcast and wanted to write in a question to get advice on a current issue I'm facing in my life. So here it goes. One of my roommates has faced a couple different types of mental illnesses, including an eating disorder and clear social anxiety, possibly depression. Years ago, I had very depression and thought about dying every day. Within the past 2 years, I turned my life around and I'm not struggling with those same depressed thoughts I once was. One day I was talking to my roommate and was experiencing how much better I feel ever since I started trying to replace my negative thoughts with positive ones. Mm-hmm. She seemed standoffish when I said this, and I was confused. About 2 months later, my roommate suddenly stopped talking to me completely. Not sure if it's related to our discussion months before or not. I noticed right away and trying to avoid confrontation, I asked my other roommate about it, who noticed the same thing. She would avoid me in the hallway of our house, and when I was in the living room, she would stay in her room and not come out until I left or went into my room. At first, I was angry. I wasn't sure why she was acting this way towards me, and it was upsetting she wasn't telling me or trying to solve the problem. After a little, I realized my anger wouldn't help solve the situation and texted her, telling her I'm sorry for whatever it is that I did and I'm willing to take responsibility for my actions, but you just simply don't know what I did. She responded shortly, saying she was just stressed out. I left a detailed coloring book and coloring pencils colored pencils in her room with a note, hoping it would help ease some tension. She never said anything to me about it. My other roommate still talks to her, and now the house is very awkward. She will pass by me and not even say hi when I do. Fast forward to 2 weeks ago, I knocked on our door and asked if we can turn a new leaf and put any disagreements we have, not sure what they are, behind us. She said yes, but now nothing is changing. I will say hi to her, but I can see her trying to avoid me. I'm very close to my other roommate who thinks the whole situation is weird and hates what it's doing to the house. We signed a 2-year lease and the second year has just started, and I can't live with someone always moping around and ignoring me. So should I just ignore her too and act like she's not there, like she does to me, or try talking to her again? I've already tried pulling whatever it is out of her at this point. I feel pathetic repeating myself to her. Please advise of what you think the best way to handle this. I'm past wanting to be friends with her again. I just want to live in a house that doesn't have such negative, awkward tension. So that's a pretty good question and pretty serious issue. So I thought it would be a really good one. A house full of women that I'm like, you know what? Sonya's going to be on. Let me get some insight that I might not have. Of course, I have my ideas, but I'd love to hear what your thoughts are to that.
Yeah, well, in this case, it sounds to me like your roommate is a version of who you used to be when you were sad and depressed and isolating yourself and felt like killing yourself. And when you confronted that pattern and said, I found a way out, would you like a hand? That pattern is pushing back. Mm-hmm. And there's this emotional and energetic resistance. So what it means to your roommate to release that pattern is that everything underneath it that creates those feelings would have to be looked at, healed, addressed, remembered, forgiven. Trauma would have to come out of her body. She might have to face some memories. There's things that created the depression and the suicidal thoughts. And some of those were also negative thoughts and beliefs and ideas that she has about herself. So there's this sense of, I'm going to have to really change inside if I'm going to give up this dark place that I'm in. And sometimes it feels very threatening to give up an identity, even if it's a very sad identity. So the first thing to do.
It's comfortable in a sense, right? You get used to who you are. And even though it's not necessarily the most positive thing, it's familiar.
It's familiar. So there's this sense of being like having her identity threatened. And then also there's this awareness of like the breaking through that stuff is not fun. It's not easy. It's painful. And it feels kind of overwhelming and scary. And so there's a sense of wanting to back away from that, even though on the other side of that is freedom and peace and joy. It's also the unknown. Yeah. So we tend to fear the unknown. So there's a couple of layers of fear there about melting down the identity, the work that it's going to take to get there, then new habits that would have to be installed, meaning I would have to consistently feed a more positive version of me. I might have to change who I'm hanging out with and what I'm doing with my spare time. You know, there's a lot of work involved. So we tend to want to stay where we know that we can survive even if we're unhappy. But the key to helping your friend is empathy. So you've tried making friends, you've tried seeing if it's something you did, you've tried taking accountability, but you maybe need to go deeper and deeper into empathy. And she may not be willing to talk about it. So at this point, you can do something really kind of magical, which is practice energetic empathy. So it's like sending her psychic emails with, I remember what that was like. And you can actually use tapping to send someone psychic emails that can help affect their field and their state of being. Now, you can't, you know, force somebody to change. And you're not like prying energetically, like poking at them. But you're basically offering them a soft feeling of love and compassion so that when she thinks of you, she feels that there's an openness instead of an estrangement. So what I would recommend is that the tap that we're about to do, this little mini tap, that you actually do it on yourself, but from the point of view of your friend, imagining that you're speaking for her and you're tapping on your body as a surrogate, doing the work that she right now is too afraid to do. So it's an advanced practice, but really anyone can do it. And when we are sending good thoughts to people, in essence, this is what we're doing, or when we're praying for people, But you can also use your body to, like, I'm going to tap on me as if I'm you and kind of loosen up some fears that they have, because most people don't want to stay stuck. They just don't know a way out. And if you can model energetically what that might look like for them, they can actually take hold of that and begin to relax.
Yeah. Yeah. What wonderful advice. And, you know, to add my 2 cents on that, it's, you know, if you can, with the person who wrote in here, there is frustration and sort of resistance to what this person is doing. So, you know, if you can then, it goes right along with having empathy, saying, you know what, I understand, and I'm going to actually accept it and send love in spite of the fact that you're ignoring me, and you've created this sort of energy in the house that I don't prefer. I'm actually going to bring love to that. And if she can do that, right, I think you're going to see a shift. And combined with doing some of this, you know, this other work, I think it's a wonderful advice to sort of, you know, send the psychic emails, as you said, you know, sending her love. And it goes right along with that without having to talk to her or sort of approach her in a way that seems maybe threatening, because you represent the death of who she is now. And it's scary for her to face it. You know, even spend part of your time envisioning what you would like her to show up as. You know, I think this is a powerful tool that we can use when you understand that, you know, people in your world, in a sense, are a reflection of your expectations as well. It's like, you know, I always say there is no out there. People are props in your movie, so to speak. So then also, sort of to wrap it all up, add sessions of envisioning what it would be like to interact with the version of her you'd like to see. Don't be attached to that. Be okay with what is, send love to what is, but then also play with the idea of what would it feel like? What would it seem like? Let me imagine and drum up the vibration of that version of reality where she has the shift and we have a different type of relationship.
That's a really, really good advice, Brandon. And I want to say the step to getting there, before we can give her empathy, before we can imagine who she could be, is to give ourselves empathy. So I would say to the questioner, first, tap for your own frustration. Acknowledge how much of a bummer it is to live with someone who's bringing the whole house down and how exhausting and stressful it is. Take the lesson of, like, oh, I moved in with people I didn't know very well, or I brought people into my life that matched the vibration I was at. This is my graduation test. Can I love the version of me that I used to be maybe for other people?
Beautiful idea. Beautiful.
You know? Resolve that inside yourself. And as you release the judgment and the pain of who you used to be and the effects that had, and you clean that up for yourself, then it's way easier to give her love from a very neutral and deeply, genuinely authentic, empathetic place.
Yeah, I love that. I'm so glad I asked this question with you on the show, because it's some amazing insight. And I think hopefully that helps the person that is looking for some guidance, and anyone else who, you know, approaches or has this sort of situation or something comparable in their life. Why don't we move into Sonya, talking about, you know, a little bit about the tap, and maybe it, you know, at this point, I always like for you to take a moment and just give a quick explanation of what tapping is, and then we can actually move into the tap and the topic that you'd like to approach today with the little mini abbreviated tap we're going to do.
Sure. So tapping is a really self-empowering technique, and I'm guessing that this is why Brandon keeps having me on this show, because he wants you all to have something that you can actually do, not just think about doing. Or, it's great to understand how things work, but then there's actually a doing piece, and tapping is a piece that you can physically do that's going to actually give you change within minutes of doing it. So I like it because it's instant gratification. It moves me forward on the daily. And what we're going to do is take our own hands, and we're going to tap gently on the energy circuits of the body, also called the meridians. They're the same lines that acupuncturists use to regulate the flow of energy in the body. And what they found is that if you tap on the circuits of the body while opening up the file folder in your brain, where your stress or your confusion or your even physical pain, wherever that memory is stored in your body, if you're thinking about it while you're tapping, the emotional intensity and the physical charge will change. The energy will begin to process out of your nervous system, no matter how long it's been stored there. And that energy comes out in the form of yawning, burping, laughing, crying, sneezing, coughing, releasing heat waves and tingles. It's a very interesting, quick way through to get this stuff out of your body. And then as the charge decreases, the emotional intensity dwindles away, you can begin to reprogram your brain with a positive thought. And that way, these positive thoughts actually become ingrained instead of having to just constantly remind myself, oh yeah, stop thinking this way, start thinking that way. You're just going to fast forward through that process, and suddenly you've got this new idea that's much easier to remember because it's really been wired in there at the basic level. And Perfect. As we know, our thoughts generate and control our reality. As you think, so you are. And whatever you think you can achieve, you actually can achieve if you'll think it long enough.
For sure. You know, it's one of my favorite quotes, Henry Ford, whether you think you can or think you can't, you're right.
Exactly. And it's not just our thoughts, it's our feelings, because our feelings is what gives our thoughts life.
Right.
It's the energy behind our thoughts. Am I saying to myself, I'm a good person, or am I actually feeling I'm a good person while I think that? So the emotional body has to be in alignment with your thoughts. You can't just gloss over a bunch of pain with these little happy thoughts, because the thoughts don't have any legs. But if you'll clean out the negative feelings along with the negative thoughts, then your emotional body and your thinking body are lined up, and then you can move mountains and create miracles.
I love it. I love it. I love it. So what is the, typically, Sonya, when you do your taps, you like to have a theme for that particular tap. What is the theme for today?
Today I want to talk about change, because I'm inspired by that question. And There's this fear of change that we all have. There's a lot of change going on in the world. People have been overwhelmed with sudden change. I know in Texas, we've just had a lot of hurricanes moving through. That's a very sudden change. Getting married is a sudden change. There's all kinds of things that, whether they're positive or negative, we have an aversion to allowing just because they're new and different. So I want to tap on change. And I'm also going to put a PDF up in the Facebook group that are some positive affirmations for people who are going through change and they want to keep some positive words going through their heads that you can actually tap and say to yourself and get those things programmed in. So what we're going to do is a call and response. I'm going to tap on me. You're going to tap on you. You can use one or two hands. I'll call out the points, tell you where they are in your body. You do the best you can. You don't have to do this process perfectly. You can be kind of near the point or, tapping a little bit randomly. As long as you're stimulating somewhere close to these points, your body's going to get the message and start to release. And just reminding you, too, that if you don't get the entire world changed in this one little mini tap, that we have resources for you to go deeper and to be consistent with this practice. Because like anything that you want to do, consistency and persistence is going to get you there.
Absolutely.
So everybody take two hands if you can, one hand if you're driving. Find your collarbones, drop underneath your collarbone, press in the front of your chest in the upper pectoral region, upper breast tissue region, until you find a sore spot in the front of your chest. It feels a little more sensitive than the other area. And give that a light, gentle massage. And take a few deep breaths. And just tune in to one aspect of your life right now that's changing, that you feel some resistance to or some fear or anxiety around. It could be big, it could be small. And that's going to be the topic of this session. So just try to focus on that subject. When I say this issue, that's going to be the issue we're talking about for you. Okay? So massaging on the chest. Now I'm going to give you some words. You repeat after me. I'll call out the points. But remember that you can change and edit these words to make them more specific for your scenario. Okay? So massaging the chest. Repeat after me. Even though I have this issue about the change around, and then you say what change is going on for you, I'm open to loving and accepting myself. Let's say that three times, massaging the points in the front of the chest. Even though I have this issue surrounding the change involving, I'm open to loving and accepting myself. Big breath. And one more time, even though I have this issue surrounding the change involving what? I'm open to loving and accepting myself. Big deep breath one more time. Good. Now we're going to tap the beginning of our eyebrows right where your eyebrows start. So tapping gently with one or two hands on the eyebrow. Tuning in to this fear around this change. Sliding down to tap on your temples right at the edge of the eye socket, gently tapping with one or two fingers. I have resistance to this change. Let's just admit that, okay? Say it again. I have resistance to this change. One more time. I have resistance to this change. Now, following that bone to the front of the cheekbone, so it's going to be under your pupils and on your cheekbones where your cheeks stick out the most in front, tapping gently. This issue, thinking again about what's changing in your life and how you feel about it. Now you're going to tap under your nose and above your top lip. How do you feel about this change? Does it scare you? Does it overwhelm you? What's the first thought that pops into your head? You're going to say that right now. I feel what about this change? Say it three times. I feel about this change. One more time. I feel. There we go. And tap under the lips on the chin. Even if part of me has some fear around this, I'm open to loving and accepting myself. Big, noisy breath. And while we're tapping, I want you to get used to strong exhalations through an open, relaxed jaw. Tapping down to the front of the chest. This fear. I don't know what to expect. So you're tapping the front of the chest in a big circle. Nice loose fingers. I don't know what to expect. And just tune into that anxiety that goes through your body because you don't know how things are going to turn out. Big deep breath again. Now we're going to tap the front of the rib cage, bottom of the ribs, where your ribs stick out in front the most. I'm open to loving and accepting myself through the entire change that's going on. Say it again. I'm open to loving and accepting myself through this entire change. Big, noisy breath. Now you're going to tap the side of the ribs. So these points are located nipple height, side seam of the body, under the arm. And you can tap by crossing your arms like a hug. And tap both sides at once if you want to. This resistance. So tuning in to the fear or the resistance that you have around this change. Let yourself feel that for a second. What comes up for you? Big deep breath. And at this point, you might feel some sensations going through your body. Some people feel a little queasy. Some people feel dizzy. Some people are burping or feeling like, whoa, all this energy is moving through my body. Just relax. Your body's actually off-gassing a ton of stored stress, and that's natural. It's good. Now you're going to tap the inside of your wrist. So look down, turn your wrist over, and tap on your wrist bone. And that bone is located on the little finger side of the inside of your wrist. So if you move your hand up and down, that bone's going to pop up and down. Tap straight across that bone. Okay? I love and respect myself, even though I don't know what to expect, and part of me wants to avoid this change. Big deep breath. So now put your hand like you're going to karate chop something. Look down at the top edge, at the side of your thumbnail, gently tapping there. I accept the part of me that wants to run away, avoid this, or deny that it's happening. Okay, let's say that again. I accept the part of me that wants to run away, avoid this, or deny that it's happening. Tap your index finger. It's too much to deal with. Let's just shout that one out. It's too much to deal with. It's too much to deal with. Big deep breath again. Tapping the middle finger. I accept the part of me that doesn't want to deal with this. Big soft breath, giving empathy to that part of you that's really thinking it's protecting you by pushing this change away. Okay, now we're going to tap the bottom of the fourth finger. Even though a part of me is afraid, another part of me is aware that this change is necessary. Big soft breaths. Tap the little finger. I don't like that it's necessary. I may not understand why it's necessary. And this is what the universe is offering me right now. Tapping the bottom of the hand on the meaty side of your hand where you would land a karate chop. Okay? Big soft breath. Just accepting that there may be something behind this that you don't understand yet that may be necessary for your own evolution, for your own growth, your own maturation process. Tap the top of the head using one or both hands and the sides of the head and the back of the head. I'm open to seeing the lesson and the beauty behind this change. Okay, tapping the eyebrows, even if I don't know what it is, tap the temples. I'm allowing myself to move forward now. Big deep breath again, to the best of my ability. Tapping your cheeks, front of the cheeks again, allowing myself to gracefully move forward, step by step, feeling my way through this to the best of my ability. Tapping under the nose, big noisy breath. I accept the part of me that wants to know how it's going to work out. Tapping under the lips. I accept the part of me that wants to know what's going to happen. Tapping down to the front of the chest in a big circle. I accept the part of me that's looking for safety here. And tap the front of the ribs. Bottom of the rib cage. I'm releasing my fear and I'm allowing myself to move intuitively through this process. Tapping the side of the rib cage, nipple height, side seam of the body. I'm allowing myself to feel safe even with all these unknown variables. Think about what those unknown variables are. I'm tapping the inside of the wrist. I'm allowing myself to feel safe, even with these unknown variables like what? Can you name a couple of them? Big deep breath. And relaxing. Tap the side of the thumb. We're almost done. Here's where you can do your what ifs and your yikes and your yeah buts. Okay, so what's the worst thing that could happen? Tap your thumb. Let's name it. What could happen? Now tap the index finger, say it again. I'm afraid of what happening. And tap the middle finger. Even if this happens, and part of me fears that it might, big deep breath, tuning into that fear. I'm open to loving and accepting myself. I'm open to getting through this. Tap the bottom of the fourth finger. I'm allowing this to be easier than I imagined and more fun than I expected. Okay, so this point we're tapping on, we've shifted sides. We're tapping the bottom of the fourth finger, the side of your fourth finger that's closest to your little finger. It's the only finger that switches from the top edge. Okay, allowing this to be surprisingly easy and more fun than I expected. Now tap the inside edge of your little finger again. Big breath and relax. Tap the bottom side of your hand, tuning into that change now. This topic that we've been working on. How do you feel about it now? Tuning in compared to where you started a few minutes ago. You notice that the stress level has decreased. Some people, it may increase temporarily. I would suggest that you rewind the tap, do the tapping again if it's increased, because it will come down. It just means that you've been defrosting some denial before you got to the real meat of it. And for others, that stress level will just come down, boop, 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 boop. Okay, so the last thing we're going to do now is tap the top of the head, and we're going to program in some really positive best outcomes. So we talked about what the worst things were that could happen. What's the best thing that could happen? Because you actually might have a little fear around the good things too. So tapping the top of the head, it's possible that what could happen? What's something amazing and beautiful that could come out of this? Tap the top of the head. Take 10 seconds to describe the positive things that could happen as a result of this change. And tapping the sides of the head. And the back of the head, keep going, describing what it could be like. Okay, big deep breath and relax. So let's check in. We'll start with you, Brandon. Tell me what your experience is.
My experience is definitely, I find it super empowering just to tap in and kind of confront those fears and blockages. And then, you know, it's just such a release to sort of confront it and say, I acknowledge that you're there and I love myself anyway. And just going through that journey and then coming out the other end where I then say, hey, let's look at the best scenario. It feels like going on a journey that is super beneficial on many levels for me. So I feel great. I feel I definitely feel like it's very productive work for me to do.
Thank you. And I think it's for all of us. I mean, this is the journey, however you're going to do it. Yeah. And some ways take a little bit longer and some ways are a little faster. And I, for one, like hacks. I want to do like, let's get in and go through, because you can't go around. You can't deny, you can't avoid, you can't really put it off, or you're just going to stay stuck. But if you can get in and get out, it's a lot less overwhelming than just kind of eking your way along over a period of months and years. Right. Especially if you've got a lot of things that you want to do in this world, you know, you've got some really beautiful gifts that you want to deliver. And if you've got memories and fears and feelings and beliefs in the way, like, let's get those out of the way so that you can give what you came here to give and be who you came here to be and contribute and feel that you have fulfilled your purpose.
Yeah, it's a wonderful, wonderful tool. And like you said, there's many ways to approach working through these blockages. For me, you know, tapping has been, ever since I had the experience of, you know, seeing you, you know, at Burning Man many years ago, and it's why I've continued to bring you on. It's such a simple and direct approach. I'm always someone who loves the hacks too. How do I get, what are the shortcuts?
Yeah.
And I feel like this is sort of a shortcut. You're going straight in, and having you to act as a guide in steering the ship, so to speak, is such a wonderful, wonderful experience. And in regards to that, for those of you who don't know, any of you have heard Sonya before, know that Sonya runs the World Tapping Circle. WorldTappingCircle.com is where, you know, she basically has folks come and sign up to, you know, tap each Monday live. And then there's an archive of all the past taps and different subjects and so forth. And Sonya has been gracious enough to offer you guys some amazing discounts to get involved in that. Sonya, why don't you take a moment to explain, if people want to continue tapping with you, what you've put together for them?
Sure. Well, I decided that the positive head people were the people most likely to change the world. So Brandon and I decided to give you guys a really good deal, because we want you to thrive and we want you to succeed and we want you to go out and do all those beautiful things and also enjoy and celebrate your process. So we created a joint webpage, worldtappingcircle.com/positive head. Where you will see the discounted positive head version. And what we decided to do for you today is something we've never done, which is to give you a month of the tapping World Tapping Circle subscription for the price of one circle, which is listed as positive day, which is the one-time access to the World Tapping Circle. And what we're going to do is give you a whole month of the World Tapping Circle for $5 with a promo code positive head, which you'll see if you subscribe to the monthly subscription. It'll pop up with, here's your promo code if you want it for $5. And then if you like it, you will be in that for $19 a month. And on my webpage, we sell that for $27 a month. So you're getting a really great discount, and you're getting in for, you know, $5 instead of $9 that we would normally charge for one circle.
Let me make sure this is clear, because it is really, really gracious and a little maybe could be confusing. So if they go to worldtappingcircle.com/positive head and they want a full month, they would click on the positive month, which says $19. Then they would put in the code positive head, and that would be reduced to $5 for that first month. Is that correct? And then
That's
it
correct.
Would continue. And then it would continue as $19 if you continue, right, each month thereafter, which is already a discount because it's $27 on your main site. So it's $5 for the month, $19 month two, and, you know, all of which is an incredible deal. Hopefully people don't get mad at you if they find out, because $5 is a big difference than $27 on your main page. So that is super, super gracious of you to offer our listeners. And I think it's, you know, you're walking the talk, so to speak, to show people, like, I'm more interested in you getting healing and help than I am in getting wealthy from this, obviously, at $5.
Yeah, that's actually true. And, you know, I've had some business people say, come on, like, really? And
yeah,
this is way too cheap. And I'm like, well, I don't want money to be an object. I don't want people to say, well, I would have done my work, but I couldn't afford it. Or I would have gotten therapy,
right,
but I didn't get childcare. Or, you know, so we've taken traveling out of it and parking places. And really the price of, you know, I charge way more than that for a private EFT session. And most counselors do as well. So if you want some really deep therapy and you're willing to be there with me live or use the video library, you will get what you came for. We promise you that.
Right. And then the other thing that I'm noticing here on our page is that's somewhat new is the chakra sweep that you did, which I think is really, really interesting. Maybe you can explain a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, we did a 7-week series where people were coming for 2 hours at a yoga studio here, and then we recorded it. And in those 2-hour sessions, I basically taught people how their chakras work, how they're connected, and then we used EFT to process issues that were blocking the flow of energy in those chakras. And it's a very thorough way to go through every area of your life, because each chakra controls a different part of your life: your creativity, your sexuality, your voice, your psychic abilities, your spiritual connection, your heart, your sense of physical happiness and well-being. They're all wrapped up in the chakras. So if you're someone who wants to really get on with your development, the chakra sweep has been recorded and put up on the Positive Head page that we're referring you to. And it's $99. Originally it was $149. And it comes with some beautiful PDFs that you'll get to download as well, where you can see the affirmations and print them and keep going.
Wow. Well, that's one that I really am really interested in doing, because what I love about it is not only having a further clarification and understanding and learning about the chakra system, but then the work to help clear the chakras, because it's one thing to understand them. And then it's like, okay. And, you know, I know one thing that I've heard, and I assume you'll agree with, different people who we're all on our own unique evolutionary path, right? And different people have different issues that are blockages for them, you know, and you know, if someone has a lot of trouble communicating, their, you know, throat chakra, it has blockage, right? Or if someone has sexual related issues, then their root chakra or sacral chakra, right? So yeah, these are different. You get to learn about all these, which I have a loose understanding, obviously, but I'd love to dive deeper into what you're teaching, and then to actually tap through and help to clear those chakras. And of course, you know, it's sort of a known thing: clear your chakras and watch how much more energy can flow into your life, because the channels are clear.
That's right. And your physical body will function better. You'll feel more intuitive and alive and aligned and joyous, for sure.
Right. Well, thank you so much, Sonya, for coming on and sharing, as always, the little mini tap there. I know it was helpful for me and helping with the question. I loved your insight. And of course, these deals that you're offering the listeners are super gracious. And guys, once again, you can go to worldtappingcircle.com/positive head. And this is where you can sign up for any of this stuff. And otherwise, you have a song that you would like to leave us with. I always like to give up the DJ controls, the DJ booth, when I have a co-host. So what do you got?
Well, I have a fun and funky version of a Stevie Wonder song called Don't You Worry About a Thing. It's kind of a dance remix. So if you want to get your boogie on and lighten up, this is a good song.
Beautiful. Well, thank you so much. I am not going to worry about a thing. Thanks to you today, Sonya. You are so lovely. And I look forward to having you back in another few weeks, month or so.
Thank you, Brandon.
Till next time, journey well. Love you all. Also, if you're craving more consciousness elevating content, be sure to check out Gaia, which is my personal go-to source for streaming consciousness content on the web, where you can stream an incredible 7,000 plus exclusive videos covering 5,000 years of wisdom. As you all hear me constantly say, it's a daily conscious effort to maintain an elevated vibration. And if you're looking to journey deep down the rabbit hole to do so, then Gaia is the best place I know of to do it, period. And you can sign up for your first month for only 99 cents at Gaia.com/positive head. That's spelled Gaia.com/positive head. Check it out.
You understand that? Yeah. Well, like, I don't understand how you can, because, like, I've been to, you know, Paris, Beirut, you know, I've been to Iraq, Iran, Eurasia, you know, I speak very, very fluent Spanish. Todo está bien, chévere.
Chévere.
Chévere. Is that right, mama? Yeah, because I got my shaking room on the little friends.
Everybody's got a thing, but some don't know how to handle it. Always reaching out in vain, just taking the things not worth having. But don't you worry about a thing. Don't you worry about a thing, mama. 'Cause I'll be standing on the side when you check it out. You say your style of life's a drag, and that you must go other places. But just don't you feel too bad when you get fooled by smiling faces. But don't you worry about a thing. Don't you worry about a thing, mama, 'cause I'll be standing on the side when you check it.
Don't you worry.